The drugs were Kelly's. Pixie swore she found them in the dorm just by accident.
I thought Kelly was a friend of yours.
Oh, not if she pushes dope. I've had my suspicions for some time. I reckon she made contacts when she was outside.
Hmm. All right, Kean. Is that all?
Yeah. Thank you, Mrs. Reynolds.
One, two, three.
Well, that should pick her up loud and clear.
Yeah, but how are you going to make her talk?
Well, I've got a plan. I'm setting it up for after tea.
Yeah, well, I hope it doesn't backfire on you.
So do I.
Dirty dog walk. You bitch!
She's by myself.
I'm busy.
Forget it, Lou. We're after Pixie, remember?
Shut up!
She's not gonna tell anybody, is she?
You'll keep right. Let's get her.
What's going on, Myra?
Just a little conversation between me and your leader.
A private conversation?
That's what they said about water.
Well, I want to hear it anyway.
Yeah, well, that's not the way I want it. Need the hard stuff, and I'll bring it in. Simple as that. You could have killed Marlene.
Yeah, well, I didn't, did I? So she's allergic to coke. There's plenty of other ways to keep her in line.
Don't you care about the women at all?
Bugger the women. Anyone who gives a stuff about it, me.
So you can stick your proposals? I'm not making deals.
Oh, very smart. What does that prove?
Oh. What do you think it proves?
You've blown it, Kean, with everybody.
Come! You must help quick. They're getting Pixie.
Pixie, otherwise we'd be using it to stitch you up.
Well, how did you find out?
A certain friend of ours seems to understand more than we gave her credit for.
Oh, thank you.
I think it's time we found out who we're thanking, don't you?
Come on, Jim. I'm not going to cause trouble. No. I just want to make sure she's all right.
No way. Now listen, Matt.
We put one foot wrong, we're going to wind up back in isolation. You let Desmond handle this. She knows what she's doing.
It's Pixie. It's Pixie. She's not like the others.
Oh, they're all the same in the dark, Sonny.
Just shut up, Frank!
You really have got the hots, haven't you?
Now, listen. That's enough. Now, I'm warning the both of you. I'll crack heads if I have to, but we stay out of this. You understand?
Your meal.
Is that how you say it?
Yes. Your meal, you say good.
Oh, well, it's a very, it's an interesting name, you know, your meal. Oh, I like it, I like it.
You got a surname, love? You know, second name.
My name, your meal.
Oh, gosh, who needs another name anyway? I think your meal's an awfully lovely name, and I think it was awfully nice of you to help me, too.
You helped me. So I not let you hurt.
Yeah, but how come you let us think you're a dummy?
What she's trying to say, Emil, is that we thought you were deaf and couldn't speak.
No speak. No say nothing. People's not friend. Not know who Emil is. You friend all. You never tell of Emil.
So far, there's not much to tell, is there?
This is very precious, isn't it?
Book. For prayer. Belong my people. My father, father. Oh, one more before.
Your great grandfather?
Yes.
Oh.
He give to me when I little girl in my home. My land. So beautiful. So far away. Gone now. Everyone.
All your family's still over there, are they? How long since you've seen them?
6. No, 7 years. I come marry man from my country. Live here long time.
You have a husband. Oh, gosh, he must be awfully worried about you.
No, he hate. I not have child. He beat many times. Oh. I run away, take car, but not know how to drive. I hit man in other car. I hurt him. Now I must stay here till end of life.
No, love. Even if you are guilty, they can't keep you here forever. Once you've served your sentence, you'll be free.
Yeah. Free? I never be free. Never. Till die is custom. My people's way.
But Judy just means you can go home when you're released.
Never. I go. Husband, kill me.
Come on, love. He wouldn't do that. You've made a mistake and you're paying for it.
You not understand. I bring shame and dishonor to husband. I disobey. In old country, people will hear my shame. All day I pray. But shame not go away. I never leave this place. I never tell name. Not shame husband. I be punished forever.
Well, what the bloody hell do we do now?
Nothing's changed.
Oh, pig, she's going to take over as top dog again.
I'm top dog. And I won't be stepping down for Desmond Bryant or Margaret Bloody Thatcher, got it?
Yeah, but how are you going to get the women on side? They're not going to like you after that tape.
They don't have to like me, as long as they're scared of me.
Oh, you mean we rough them up a bit?
Oh, you've got to be joking.
Oh, there wasn't anything I could do.
Oh, shut up and keep knit. Now I'm going to need muscle, and you three are going to provide it. But don't worry, you'll get paid.
Well, what about Desmond? She's real trouble.
Steer clear for now. When the time's right, I want her. Got that? She's mine.
I didn't mean to go off the deep end or anything, Jeff. It's just that she seems like somebody who ought to be protected. That's
okay, mate. You've all been there sometime.
Well, I'm buggered if I know where I am. I mean, I think she's nice and I like her. I really do like her, but Frank, he just keeps going on about sex all the time. I don't know where I am. How do you tell the difference?
Well, between sex and love. You certainly pick the hard questions, don't you? It took me years to work that one out.
To come up with an answer?
Yeah, but I don't know if it'll suit you. See, I reckon if you care about somebody and you just enjoy being with them. It's the most important thing.
Yeah,
hello, I'm not saying sex isn't important. And I know we're missing out here, but yeah, if I could just meet a woman I could talk with. Yeah, I'd be friends with her. Yep. And share things with. Now, that's the dead giveaway. If you can find somebody you can share things with, then I reckon you're home and hosed. You know what I mean?
Yeah. You'd have to get to know that person pretty well, wouldn't you? Makes love at first sight seem a bit of a joke. Yeah.
It's sex at first sight, old son. Love comes later.
I hope we're here long enough to find out.
I hope I'm here long enough to screw myself in the floor.
Shut. Why don't you go to bed?
Don't you want to hear the details, Macca? Guaranteed to keep you in wet dreams for a week. Oh, God, I was twice as hot thinking of how Spud would like to be getting his rocks off with a screwing Lou in the loo. Hey, Macca, that's poetry. Rhymes.
I'm going to bed.
I was putting a good word for you, Macca. I'm moving. Onwards and upwards. You get me drift? Oh, Lou's okay. But she wants it too bad. Now, Pixie, all legs and gooey eyes. I could rub my hands up those thighs till she begged.
Shut up, Frank!
Hit a nerve, did I, Patty? Tell you what. You be a good boy, and I might let you watch.
Hmm? Oh, that's enough. Knock it off!
Oh, take it easy. I was kidding.
Oh. You're about as funny as a kick in the crutch. Now, I don't care how many women you have. If they're stupid enough, it just serves them right. But you lay one finger on that girl, and I'll put you out of action permanently. And I'm not kidding.
When I saw him first, and I wish he'd just stay out of my way.
Why don't you leave him alone?
But
he'd been growing on him like a wart.
Oh, yeah, well, look, I can't see him falling over himself to get to you.
Well, how can he? You're such a bloody great lump.
Oh, thanks. I saw him first.
Big deal.
If you two could possibly drag yourselves away from such intellectual conversation, it's time for Ben.
All I'm asking is, don't cramp my style.
Well, you don't have to worry about that. Matt and me ever find your bloody style, we wouldn't touch it with a 10-foot pole.
Where's the new Queen of Wentworth, Desmond?
Check the toilet block. That's where she feels most at home.
Oh, Desmond, that's no way to talk about your top dog.
I wouldn't blink if I were you, Miss Ferguson. You might miss something.
About time, too. You know, I'd say the honeymoon is just about over.
All that lot of stuff on their faces. They've got work to do.
Ladies first.
Now I've heard everything. Desmond, a lady.
Shut up, Kean, and serve the breakfast.
Well, come on, Myra. Let me do my good deed for the day.
Look, I'm not a little old lady, and you're not a Boy Scout, so cut the good deeds. I don't need that crap around here, and I don't need handouts.
Well, if you can't tell the difference between a handout and good manners, I'm sorry for you.
You'd be to blame me, Neil. It's your husband that's beating you.
Because I bad wife. Not give husband child.
But that's not necessarily your fault.
Yeah, well, I mean, maybe it's his fault. Maybe he's the one who can't have children.
Yeah.
Husband? This cannot be. His shame of wife.
Yeah, it's a shame, all right. It's a crying shame. You wouldn't even be in here in the first place if you hadn't stolen that car to get away from the bastard.
Better I be here. Then shame family.
Oh, that's crazy.
Not to your meal, it isn't.
God.
Keep it down. I don't want the screws to see her talking.
Yeah, well, if some bloke did that to me, I'd just find someone else.
Yeah, well, good for you.
No, this is not permitted. I never go out of house.
Never?
Never. Without husband.
Must be crazy.
No, not crazy, love. Just different. Oh, damn, I have sugar.
Anyone have any sugar?
Yeah, you can have this.
Put it down, Matt. She wants it, she can get it a still.
Brother. And she was only pretending to be nice so that we'd make her top dog. And as soon as we did, oh gosh, Ray, it was terrible. She was so nasty to everybody, she didn't care one little bit about it.
Listen, babe, you're a sweetie, but sometimes you get things mixed up. Reb is good. Heavens, I should know. She saved my job, didn't she?
No, no, no. She would only have done that for a reason. Now think about it.
Perhaps you're right, but no, it can't be. It must be a mistake.
Well, poor Marlene wasn't a mistake when Reb gave her all those terrible drugs. I mean, she could have died.
My Reb? When she was so sick, Reb did that?
That's what I've been trying to tell you.
Whew. This is terrible. I believe her. I feel like a...
A silly sausage. I know. Don't feel bad about it. I mean, she fooled all of us.
Nobody makes a fool out of me. Nobody.
What have we got if we got there? The chuckle said we can't do any work today because all machines are broken down.
Yeah, that'd be impossible. Bobby here would have it fixed in no time.
Yeah, that's a problem with living with a genie.
No,
now, don't you worry about a thing. Keep quiet the way you've been doing and we won't give you away.
Thank you. You are free.
Oh, my God.
Check the other doors, Jude.
Yeah.
Oh, no, not me. Walk me.
Why would anyone do something like this?
Not very hard to figure.
Well, it's a mess. I guess they're all like that.
Righto, what are you up to now?
Oh, be our guest. This is just a sample. We've got others to show you if you don't like this one.
Hey, some bastard's given me celery all going over.
Oh, do tell. Surprise, surprise.
Well, you better get it cleaned up and hurry. You've still got work quotas to fill.
Fair go. Our cell's been wrecked. Aren't you going to do anything about it?
You want to tell me who did it? Fair enough. I'll just make out a report to the governor. But it's still got to be cleaned up, so get stuck into it.
Lou? Oh, she would have had something to do with it. She's not pulling the strings, though. I think Kean has just declared war.
This is ridiculous. I can walk. I have to when I get out of the car anyway.
Now, Nugget, I'd swap with you.
Besides, you're not nearly as strong as you think you are, Mrs. Morris.
If you need me, even if it's just for a chat, give me a call and I'll come round.
Thanks. But I think I have to be the one to make that decision.
Let's get you into the car.
Of her to give free drugs if you like that sort of thing, but honestly, I don't think you should encourage people in their bad habits, do you?
What's the matter with her?
Nothing's wrong with her. Excuse me.
I've got a little job for you.
I already have a job. Now let me get on with it.
You've got a job because I saved it for you. Don't forget that. Now, I did you one hell of a favor. It's your turn.
What sort of favor?
Oh, thinking of opening a little shop. Nothing fancy. Just a few pills, grass, bottles of booze. You're going to bring them in.
No.
Now, you listen to me. If I hadn't written that letter, you'd be out in your ear by now. Maybe it's time I told the freak she can have you.
You're a mean, vicious little bitch. I've got the letter, not you, so don't make any threats. You fooled everyone, even me, but you shouldn't have hurt poor Marlene. You know what I think of you? That's what I think of you. You're a pusher. Get off my way.
Does something about this episode seem strange to you?
Certainly does, Governor. Most of the damage was done to private property. You know, photos, radios, that sort of stuff.
Which means it was directed to the women and not the department. We've got a vendetta on our hands.
Yes, it wouldn't surprise me. We'll have Buckley's for finding out who, though. They'll clam up the minute we start asking questions.
Well, all I can suggest is keep your ear close to the ground. Someone's upset about something. The sooner we find out, the better. Oh, and thanks for the prompt report.
Oh, it's my pleasure, Mrs. Reynolds. If I could have a moment?
I'm sorry, Len. Something else?
Yeah, it's young Bobbie Mitchell. I suppose it's no secret how I feel about the kid.
Yes, I know that.
Yeah, well, I've got this firm of electricians, and if the department would give the nod, I reckon I could swing her an apprenticeship.
An apprenticeship? I think that's a marvellous idea. Mind you, I don't know what the department would think. She has blotted her copybook a few times.
Yeah, well, I don't think she'd foul up this time. Anyway, it wouldn't hurt to try, would it?
No, it wouldn't. But I think we ought to keep it under our hats for the time being. No point in getting our hopes up yet. Yes? Oh, would you get Joe Hagen to fetch her for me, please? Thank you. Well, now we might find out something about Jane Doe. The doctor's just arrived.
So many people who care. I
don't think you wanted all the fuss, but it seemed right somehow.
Phil.
That's what tears are for. Leave the tears here with Phil and get on with your life.
Your sentiments or his?
Both. I'm sure he wouldn't have wanted you to spend the rest of your life mourning.
I know. But it isn't that easy to just walk away. I keep thinking about that last night. That awful fight. Oh, if only he knew how I felt.
He knew. At least I'd like to think he did.
Yes. We should have brought some flowers.
Maybe next time.
No. No next time.
There's nothing wrong with the eardrums or the larynx, as far as I can tell. If she is a mute, it could be psychosomatically induced, some sort of shock. but that's out of my field.
Well, do you think she should go to audiology for tests?
Certainly can't hurt. I'll give her a thorough going over, though, first. See what we can find.
All right, now we just have to take your clothes off. Look, there's nothing to be afraid of.
Now do it, Sister Sue.
Come on.
Calm down, we're not going to hurt you.
No!
Well, that certainly answers that question, doesn't it?
No! You don't touch! It's forbidden! You leave! You leave me!
Oh, no, no, love, this is too much. What did I tell you?
One for each person and one for the pub.
This is for tea. This is soul. Just a soup song. That's enough. Too much is bad for you. Please, try to remember.
Oh, sorry. Gosh, I'm a duffer, aren't I?
Well,
I'll just take some.
Nearly as much mess in here as there was in the cells this morning. But then you wouldn't know about that, would you, Kean?
Any reason why I should?
Oh, I thought the top dog knew everything that went on around here. Unless, of course, the women have had a change of heart.
The women don't have any say in it. And as long as I got that letter, neither do you.
How careful!
Well, your little friend seems a bit huffy this morning.
Well, it's her problem, and please don't call her my friend. We're certainly not friends.
Really? Thought you two were pals. Regular pen pals, in fact.
Miss Ferguson, please don't play any games with me. If you've got something to say, please say it. If not, go. I'm very busy.
You still got the letter?
Oh, now we're talking. I've just heard what Rep said. This is all wrong. The letter is for my protection only, nobody else's. From now on, I'll take care of Ray Proctor only.
Myra?
I promised I wouldn't say anything.
Then how can I help her? I know she can speak,
but if speak with you, but not tell name to shame family. This I never do.
She feels that she shamed her husband. If the family find out that she's in here, they'll lose face in the community.
I see.
Not mean to hurt anyone. I'm sorry.
You realize I'll have to put you on a charge?
Charge?
Punishment.
But why? Women show body only to husband. It's shameful for doctor to look.
But he was only trying to help. Doesn't she understand that?
I don't think she does, Mrs. Barry. In fact, I'd be very surprised if she's ever seen a doctor before. She's been kept in a house, treated almost like a slave. She hasn't even been out on her own.
Is this true?
It's tradition.
No wonder she doesn't want to get out of here.
Look, do you have to put on a charge? She's been through a nightmare already.
All right. But you will have to apologize at... say sorry to Officer Hagen and the others. And if there's any more trouble, you'll be put in solitary. That means you'll be locked up by yourself. Do you understand?
Yes, thank you.
Come along.
Thanks. I'll keep an eye on her.
Are you sure you feel up to it?
Why wouldn't I?
Oh, from what Kean said, I thought you were in need of a rest.
Ah, yes. Well, that was yesterday. I'm a very fast healer.
Where do you think you're going?
To the dining room. Someone's got to set up.
Pixie's doing that. You can sweep up the floors.
Sweep up the floors. Take out the rubbish. All the crap jobs. You're really pushing your luck, Proctor.
No, madam. Only you. And you know why? Because you're hurting my friends and I won't ever do what you told.
Yeah, well, nobody talks to me like that. Huh? You're going the right way to end up a sliced fruit.
Give me that knife.
Yeah, where's
the
knife?
Get out of my kitchen! Get out of my kitchen! Do you hear me? Get out!
Well, this'll keep us going. I do a pretty mean omelette, but you're out of eggs.
Chris, really, I don't think...
Come on, dig in. It's all right. Just have some coffee and a bit of a talk. And if you don't feel like talking, send me home.
I'm afraid if I start, I won't be able to stop.
Then don't. Look, I hope you don't mind. I've done a bit of homework. I know about your first husband and about your son.
Marty. Well, we didn't see eye to eye for a while. No wonder he joined the Navy. Oh, everything's fine now. But I just don't seem to be able to make my personal life work.
Nonsense.
Is it? When I married Bob, I thought, this is it. This is the most important thing in my life. 2 years later, we were divorced.
So you picked the wrong man, that's all.
Oh, I don't know anything anymore. Perhaps this baby's my future.
Hey, come on, Meg, you can't mean that. I mean, we're not just talking about today and tomorrow. We're talking about the rest of your life. You think about that.
Murray, you. Lavelle?
Yep.
Oh, right. And a postcard for you, Bobby.
Ah, beauty, thanks, Mrs. Spence.
And Greenway. That's all today, ladies.
Oh, I'm so nervous, I can barely open it.
Wonder if it's from Mum. Well, there's only one way to find out.
Hey, what do you know? It's from Dennis the Menace. Reckons he's coming to Australia and he's going to come and visit us.
Oh, great.
Dennis the Menace, that's your boyfriend, isn't it?
Oh, no. He's a screw. Really nice one, though.
I haven't got a boyfriend. Still looking back.
Oh, yeah, well, we should look elsewhere, eh?
What does it take to get through to you, rabbit?
Me? You're so thick you weren't born, you were quarry.
Now cut it out, you bitch.
Both
me.
Of you cut it out and scat. Come on.
Thanks.
It's okay. You look like you needed rescuing.
Oh, no, they're okay. Actually, that Marlene, she's pretty funny.
Yeah, she can be when you're in the mood, and you obviously weren't in the mood.
I wish I was outside with the others, but I can't work yet, and I feel a bit out of place in here.
Yeah, well, look, don't mind us. Our bark is a lot worse than our bite. And at the moment, if they had to choose between you and Robert Redford, he wouldn't get a look in.
She must be hard up. I didn't mean that. I mean, someone like Pixie. She'd have lots of boyfriends, wouldn't she?
Lots of husbands, love, but no boyfriends. You like Pixie, do you?
Yeah. I wouldn't do anything or nothing. It's just that she's really nice, a friend. I've never met anyone quite like her.
There is no one quite like Pixie.
That's from my sister, Sally. She goes on to say, Mum's been sick, so I haven't told her about you yet, but I will as soon as she's better.
Sally, honey, that's a nice name.
Yeah. I still can't believe I've got a sister, 2 years younger. Wow, I can boss around.
She's still at school?
Yeah, I think so. Hold on. No, she's looking for a job, but she's not having much luck. She goes on to say, as soon as Mummy's better, we'll come and see you. We can't wait to meet you.
That's great.
Oh, I'm glad you're all here. I've got something to say.
Yeah, well, maybe we don't want to hear it.
Well, I'm still top dog, fat stuff. I've been thinking about your welfare. Seems to me all your stuff got wrecked this morning because you didn't have enough faith in me.
She did it, didn't she?
Shut up, Granny. I think you need a little insurance. Nothing much, just 50 cents a week to protect your property.
Oh. What? What about my Walkman? It was wrecked.
Yeah, now, that's too bad, isn't it, Bobby? If you'd had insurance, it wouldn't have happened. Oh, and from now on, I'll be collecting half your buy-up.
Oh, are you kidding? Come on, Dad.
Lou will collect it.
Get lost.
I need something to cover my overheads. You can buy it back. Think about it. Hey, Bunny Bryant, you get that cockroach of yours in here tonight.
You made a bet, and you're going to stick to it.
Why didn't you do something?
Not my job, remember?
But you put her in her place. That was the time to take over.
Nope. The time's not right yet. Besides, I know you're asking, but you're not everybody.
Well, what the hell do you want then? An engraved invitation?
Yeah. Something like that.
I think it would have been much more sensible if Meg had have stayed with Norm and me. I mean, isn't there anything we can do for her?
No, Joyce. Having a baby at her age is bad enough without losing Philip as well.
A baby? Meg and Philip were having a baby? Oh, Mrs. Reynolds, this is just dreadful. Well, that settles it. I'll call in on the way home. That poor girl...
I don't think that's a very good idea, Joyce.
Well, of course it is. Can you imagine how she must be feeling? She can't be left alone. Oh, that's one good thing about split shifts. Gives you plenty of time to get things done.
Yes.
Well, I'll see you in the morning. Oh, and if Norm calls, would you tell him that I might be a little bit late? No. No, don't bother. I'll call him from Meg's myself. Goodbye.
Oh, hell.
Why
don't you just leave him alone, Bob? I reckon you're embarrassing him, okay? So stand aside and let the expert show you how it's done.
Oh, I'm embarrassing him, sure. Now I've heard everything.
Oh, gee, you've got lovely hair, Matt. Do you reckon mine's nice?
I did not say that.
You did say it nearly made me puke. It was so pathetic.
Bull. Anyway. That's got nice hair.
Oh, yeah. I reckon it'd be really soft, too.
All over his body.
Well, I'll let you know after rec period.
Oh, with your technique. Get a spunk, get many. He almost ran out of the room vomiting, I reckon.
Oh, you stupid little bitch. Watch what you're doing now. Put those back in the washer.
I was only putting them on the shelves where they're meant to go.
Yeah, well, don't answer back either. Oh.
Myra, for God's sake.
Oh, save your breath, Bryant. And anyone else who helps her will be taken off the drug list. That's a real pity. Because a little dicky bird told me there's smack coming in soon. Good one, eh, Desmond?
Myra, you've got to do something. Everybody wants you back.
Yeah, Myra. Please.
Ma'am, who's everybody?
D&E block, workshop, maternity.
Us?
Honest, everybody wants you back.
Looking after things, Kean, but I'm back now.
Pigs, yeah, rack off.
You won't argue, will we? All right.
Right, you stupid bitch. Have the press, big deal. But I warn you, all of you, you'll be top dog for a bloody long time, will you?
Well, what do you know? If it isn't Ahab, the Arab.
How are you, Walkface?
Please, let me pass.
Let you pass, eh? Well, go on then, if you can. But first you've got to pay the toll, see? One for bashing me in the shower block. And one for Pixie! Okay, Camel. I'll let you pass this time, but you keep out of my way in future.
Well, I'm not blaming Anne. I know it was an accident. But why did she have to pick Joyce?
Well, at least she let you know. Imagine if Joyce had turned up and wanted to take you shopping for baby clothes.
Don't joke about it, Chris. And don't you dare run out on me when she comes.
Promise. I'll get it.
You promised.
Oh, Joyce, what a nice surprise.
Oh, Meg. Oh.
We just got to get into some exercise before the race, the last chance we're going to get.
Okie doke, I'll meet you in the rec room.
Oh, no, you don't.
What?
Leave me holding the baby while you play silly buggers with Mighty Matt.
Oh, get out. You come with me then.
You come with me.
Okay, so I use the fast one, but what do I do with the other one?
Flush it down the loo, who cares?
As long as we clean up on the betting.
That's another thing. How do you know they'll bet against him?
They'll do as they're bloody will tell.
It's a relief, isn't it? For a while there, I didn't know what you were going to do.
No, I did. I'm going to get some fags, catch up with you.
I should get up smoking.
Bitch, you're going to have to do something about her sooner or later.
Yeah, I just decided it's going to be sooner.
There you go. Cute little fella, eh?
Is beetle?
Nah, cockroach.
Oh!
Yeah, but he's upmarket, but. Peri placenta or something. Peri. Pix knows all the foreign words. Peri.
Como. We used to make ashtrays out of his records when we were little.
Ashtray for cockroach?
Nah, he doesn't smoke.
Nah, it's done his grave. Oh. Hey, Emil, you okay?
I hurt here. Lou pushed basket at me.
Skip? Rotten bitch. Tell Myra. She'll fix it.
No make trouble.
Yeah, but you've got to tell Myra. She's the top dog. She'll look after it for you. Look, if you don't tell
her,
I will.
All right. I tell.
How's it going?
He's fab. Most fantastic, fastest little fella that ever climbed out of a compost heap. Aren't you, boy?
Can I hold him for a bit?
No, no. He has to calm down before his race.
But I'm supposed to be the trainer.
Well, who said you weren't his trainer? Okay. Now, I wouldn't ask you to do this if I didn't think you could do it. But you're the fastest little fella out, and together I know we can win this. Right, boy?
Oh, honey, yeah.
No! Bad people turn around!
What's this racket about?
Bad man, spider!
Kean, hold it right there. Now, Kelly, care to tell me who started all this?
No one.
Yeah, the same no one who dubbed you into the governor?
It's a lie. It's a vicious lie.
Oh, no, Kean. You'd turn yourself in if you thought it'd get you anywhere.
You bitch. You sold me out on your own racket. I'll bloody kill you.
Now, Kelly. Oh. You all right, Desmond?
I'll live.
Really surprised at you, Kean. Bashing a prisoner, wrecking a cell, pushing dope.
Shut up, Ferguson. I might just tell somebody to post a letter.
I don't think so, Kean. You see, I've been having a little chat to a friend of yours, and you know your little friend doesn't like you anymore. You're on your own, Kean. You're finished.
Bitch!
Thank you, Kean. You've just done me a huge favour. You've earned yourself a trip to Blackmoor. But first a little stint in solitary, eh, to cool off? Now do I have to drag you there?
No, thanks. I know the way.
I say give her a couple of days and she'll be on our backs again. You wait, she'll get round Reno somehow.
No way. The freak is going to transfer her to Blackmoor if she has to carry her there on her back.
Yeah, you're right. Don't think Reb's going to get herself out of this one.
No. Yeah, well, now we've got a real top dog. Doesn't matter where she is, does it?
Well, thanks for the vote of confidence. I hope you remember that next time we have a run-in.
Mm. Reb have shame for all. Not made more trouble.
Amen to that.
And thanks to you. Otherwise, things could have been very different.
Yeah.
Well, how about we all have a little celebration for Myra, right? Yeah. Hey,
come on. Thank you. I'm glad to be back and get out. I know I made a few mistakes last time, but from now on we're a team, okay? Yeah. Everything up front and we trust each other.
Sounds good to me.
Yep.
Celebrating a bit early, aren't you, Warren? Farlap's going to clean you out tonight.
Oh, yeah.
All that money. Might have to go into business for myself.
Beat
Make
it,
a
Kelly.
Change, not to have to split the take.
You're giving us indigestion. She's a real little sweetheart, that one.
Charmer.
Do you reckon she'll try to take over, Myra?
Yeah, I reckon she'll try.
What's she doing now? She's already cleaned the place from top to bottom.
God knows. If she stays here much longer, she'll end up getting our dinner.
It's been a lousy afternoon, hasn't it?
Well, it would have been if you hadn't stayed. Oh, if only she wouldn't go on so much about bassinets and nurseries.
Well, don't let her get to you. Don't let Joyce cully your judgment.
Don't worry, she won't. In fact, she's made me see there's only one way out. I've made up my mind. I'm going to have an abortion.
I was thinking, maybe you got cold feet. All six of them, eh?
Hey, Myra, will you give me a hand getting this thing on? I can't get the bloody thing on.
Never thought I'd see you into this.
Into this
barracking nonsense.
Oh, well, it helps burn up a bit of steam, you know, after all that Reb business. And I can't see myself ever getting to a real Melbourne Cup, huh?
So where's Laurel and Hardy and the overgrown weevil?
They'll be here. They're probably running him round the block to get rid of the excess energy.
Yeah. I wouldn't worry because our bloke's going to beat the pants off yours.
You bet. I just had a mental picture of a cockroach in pants.
Okay, here come the cheerleaders, ladies. Look at them kicking their little six legs high. Yes, of course, Governor, the decision must be yours, but if you ask
Please,
me, I...
let's not lie to each other.
We both know that you've been trying to get Kean out of here for a very long time. However, this time I happen to agree with you. She's nothing but trouble. In fact, I wouldn't be surprised if she was behind the Higgins murder, so let's get her out of here once and for all.
If you say so, Governor.
I'll arrange the transfer tomorrow. But right now, I've had enough for one day.
Oh, my God! Governor!
Bloody hell, calm down, will you? Jeez, Ozzy's the one who's racing, not you.
Yeah, I know, I've got to psych him up. Cockroaches are really sensitive little critters, you know? That's why they've got those feelery tubs. What's that smell?
Hey, it smells a bit like that stuff.
Mr. Murphy, you haven't been spraying, have you? You might kill my bed bugs or something.
Well, if you've got any bed bugs, they won't be biting tonight. Could look after me girls. About time that place was sprayed.
Well, would it be true? Ozzie!
Hey, young, wait at the gate.
Don't tell me. You want to remember me just the way I was, right? Maybe I could arrange an autographed photo for you.
I'll remember you all right, Kean. I've waited a long time for this.
Really like the old movies, don't you, Ferguson? I've waited a long time for this. You had your knife out for me from the minute I came into this dump.
You're wrong, Kean. To me, you were just another bit of scum then. But I got to know you, didn't I? And now you owe me. You owe me for my father, for my job, and the million little things I've had to take from you. You owe me, and I'm gonna collect.
Nice stuff. Could almost feel sorry if I didn't know what a crooked, two-faced bitch you really are. Whatever I am, whatever I've done, I'm never hidden behind the law the way you do. You're a joke, Ferguson. You wouldn't have the guts to face anyone without that uniform.
Kean, you're off to Blackmoor in the morning. But that's not the end. Your troubles are just starting. You see, I've got some very good friends at Blackmoor, and I know they're going to make you feel real welcome.
Yeah, well, I'm not finished yet, bitch. Listen, freak. I'll be back.
I'll be back for you. You hear me?
He used to give me roses. I wish he could again. But that was on the outside, and things were different then.